we have to point out, there's a will involved for him, for Patrick Marleau, 97 draft, second pick overall, to last this long. How has he done it?
You gotta love the game to start with, and you gotta stay in great shape, and you gotta be a consummate pro, and that's what he is. He's a phenomenal skater, stays in good shape, loves to play the game, and that's a big part of it. He's having fun, and he goes to the Leafs, and he's been a bit of a mentor, and he's done a great job with Austin Matthews, Mitch Marner, and that's one reason why Lou Lamoriello, when he was the GM, brought Marleau over, not just for his scoring ability and his skating, but to show these guys, make sure these young guys, they have a lot invested in, learn the right way, learn how to be a pro and how to handle themselves, because when you play that many games, you're playing a lot of times with a lot of little injuries, you're not feeling good, and you're sucking it up, and you're there for your teammates. So great job, Patrick Marleau. Congratulations. Well earned.
Hartsey, when he talks about the veteran presence and the impact, because he said at the time, I said to him, wow, Lou talked about his disposition. And Scotty said, there's that, but he's also going to help him on the ice. Help us understand both pieces of that.
Well, yeah, when you're a kid growing up, you're obviously watching the NHL. You're watching the key players that are forward. You know, I'm sure you were looking up to, you know, some of the best stars when you were a kid on the TV. So Patrick Marleau is one of those guys. He's always, you know, on the top of his team in scoring, the highlight goals, the speed, like you said, plays both ends of the ice. And, you know, when you get a guy like that in your dressing room, there's, you know, a little star factor for these young kids. A lot of them are, you know, 18 to 22 years old that, you know, really idolize this guy growing up. So to have that effect, and like you said, he can still skate in this league. Mm-hmm. That's what you need to do in this NHL today. And you know, he's still getting points. He's making a difference in a positive way, and very exciting for him.
I like that you said star factor. When I sat across from Patrick Marleau leading up to the 2016 Cup, he's this close to that triple gold that Canadians and all hockey fans treasure. He was so modest about the fact, because he has been so good for so long. In order to have this kind of longevity from the player's perspective, what has he had to do?
Just work hard. Work hard and come to play every night and take care of yourself in the off season. All those things, preparation. You don't take any nights off. You don't take summers off. You got to be ready all the time. And the way you act and the way you carry yourself, Marleau's done that forever. And I mean, he loves the game. You have to love the game. Some guys get tired of this game. This guy, he loves hockey. Mm-hmm. To play this long, you have to love the game first and foremost. And most of us all do love the game. But you got to stay healthy, and like I said before, you got to be fairly tough to play with a lot of little injuries. You know how it is, Scott. You're never 100%. If you're 100%, you're not playing hard enough. You always have something that's bothering you. Not that you go in the training room, but that's what Patrick Marleau has had to go through. You know, he's had a battle through injury to play that many games and play that well for so long. But his biggest gift is his speed, his skating. He's effortless. Gets to the net. Fantastic player to watch. And he was, I mean, San Jose missed him there for a little while. They got Evander Kane.
Sure.
So you miss that speed. This is a speed game, and that's what's helped Patrick Marleau stay in the game, because he's always had that speed. It's a north-south game, and he can play north-south with the best of anybody.
We love sports because we love stats. It's great to be able to quantify things. And here, our research team is amazing. Look at what they came up with here. As long as we're talking about Scots, look at these guys. Great Scots.
Yeah.
All-timers. Those are some big names with a very common first name. Hartsey, right up there among the all-time leaders in games played with the name Scott.
Great Scott.
There you go.
There you go. See what he did there.
Witty.
One thing there, too, you got to be able to adapt. You know, when you play 20 years.
True.
It was the hooking, games changed. The holding.
Yes.
It was the physical kind of game. You know, when you obviously excelled as a D-man, and then it went from the no red line and then no obstruction. And, you know, he was able to, you know, obviously have a smooth transition there because of his speed. And, you know, he was able to get more points. I think his stats show in those years there, he was unreal. And even now, even when with more speed, he's still being effective. So to play 20 years in this sport, you have to be able to adapt, and he's one of the few guys left of that age group.